Welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited today. We've got two amazing lip sets. I probably can't pronounce S's. Two amazing lip sets to show you today. I'm gonna put them to the test. I'm gonna do swatches and basically tell you which one I prefer. So keep on watching. It's been so cold in Dubai. I can't imagine anyone thinking that we'll be wearing winter clothing essentially, and we're in the middle of a desert, so it's a little bit strange. I've actually just fairly recently, I suppose, started buying some winter clothes. I've been preparing because we're going to the UK very, very soon, and I know it's going to be absolutely freezing, and I'm not one of those people who like being in the cold. So I've got all my clothes prepared, all of my winter jumpers and my coats, sweaters, really, really cozy. And today I'm wearing this sweater, I think you say, yep. It's a light knit sweater from ASOS. And what I love about it is just like a simple gray one with a kind of round neck. But what I love are these star patches, which I think are meant to be at my elbow, but doesn't quite reach there. Let me like adjust. There we go. So that is what I'm wearing because it's really cold. And my skin has just been going a little bit haywire. Everything is so dry. I've been putting on so many different types of masks, all of them kind of hydrating, full of really good hyaluronic acids and all that good stuff, trying to inject some form of loveliness to my skin again, and it's just not doing it. Anyway, so my lips are really chapped. I've tried moisturizing, they're still kind of peeling and all that stuff. It's been really horrifying. So today we are going to be trying out some really lovely lipsticks. I picked up these sets at separate times at my local Sephora. Really excited to see them because I've been kind of seeing them filtering through. Got them sort of during the Christmas rush, and the first one I saw was the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick set, and it looks absolutely amazing. It's this one, and it basically comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 mini liquid of her Everlasting Liquid lipsticks, and there are 3 milliliters, so 0.1 fluid ounces in each of them. So they're kind of deluxe sizes, they're not the full sizes, and the colors just look amazing, like a really great variety of different things, including shades, where I think I'm a little bit wary of. And I just saw this and thought I have to pick it up. I really love her Everlasting Liquid Lipstick formula. They are absolutely amazing, and I just wanted to try more colors essentially, so I picked that up. And then I saw the Marc Jacobs set, and how can you say no to this? It's just like this beautiful hot pink shininess that called to me. And this one is actually like a mini set of a's. So this is called the Up All Night Collection, and it has 5 of his mini Marc Jacobs lip cream collection, I want to say. Le Marc Lip Creme, it says. And this one has 1.7 grams or 0.05 ounces. So it's actually a little bit less than what you get in the Kat Von D. And there's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 of them here. Both of them are about the same pricing, I think, or around the same range. So I wanted to put them to the test and see which one is actually worth it and worth picking up. So let's get started. First thing we're going to try is the Marc Jacobs, because it's a creamy formula. So I think it's going to be a little bit easier to pick, to kind of take off. I'm not going to try every single shade on my lips because I think I'll just be dying at that point and my lips will be forever just irretrievable and refuse to speak to me. So I'm going to try a couple of shades from each of them and try them out. I'm going to swatch all of them at the back of my hands and show you what they actually swatch like and how they basically feel. So I figured if I try a couple of shades from each, it'll give me a pretty good kind of understanding of what the formula is like. Now, I've already tried the Kat Von D. I've got the full size, and I've got a few shades, so I kind of know they are quite of the kind of very general matte liquid lipstick, but I've not tried anything from Marc Jacobs lipstick line. Now, I'm gonna leave a couple of videos down below. I haven't had the most success with Marc Jacobs cosmetics, but that is not to say that these wouldn't be a hit. Now, in the I'm opening up the Marc Jacobs set, and it comes very nicely wrapped in tissue paper, and what I just really like was the fact that you get a bag with it. So I think all the lipsticks are housed inside, and this is a Marc Jacobs bag, and it's got the most lovely tassel. I don't know if you can see that, it's just so nice, and it's that same hot metallic pink as the box that it comes in. And usually, so I have a lot of these little makeup bags that comes in sets, and they're usually kind of okay, and they get thrown to the back of the cupboard, and that's where they basically stay. This one just seems really nice. I'm kind of hoping I could use it as a going out bag as well. So if we open it up, this is what it looks like on the inside. It's just kind of feels like it's easily clean material. Just says Marc Jacobs, and then you've got the five mini lipsticks in here. And if I'm not mistaken, yeah, it completely lifts off. So let's take that off. So it just comes in extra packaging, like so. You can take it out, and then you're left with the actual bag, and it's just quite sizable. So that is super, super cute. Like, I would totally use this, and it's quite, feels quite durable and hard, and don't know whether it's easily scratchable though. That's what I'm a little bit concerned of. But otherwise, the bag itself is super cute. I don't think I own any Marc Jacobs fashion items either. So cute, really props up for that. I'm gonna put that aside because what we're interested in is the actual makeup. So let's drop everything down. And you have these five. Now, can't actually throw the box away because I have to tell you what's in there. Now, just dropping everything now. Now, it says, it looks like there's two nudes, one called No Angel, another is Slow Burn, followed by O'Miley, Miss Scarlet, and Scandal. And I'm hoping they are. They're so cute. Look at that. I think this is an exact mini replica of the normal Le Marc lip creme. So it's just a smaller size. It's got the name on the bullet. And I think it just, yep, it just pulls. Oh, it's so tiny. Oh my God. This is, I can't. Like, I have small hands. This is so, so tiny. Like, if I just. It's literally a teeny tiny replica. I can't imagine, like, it's that's about the size of my finger. And I have really tiny fingers anyway, so super small. But it's quite nice. I mean, I like the fact that it's a mini replica size, and that's what you get. So this one is called No Angel, and it is a brownie nude. So I'm gonna swatch that at the back of my hands. Ooh, it's kind of like a creamy matte formula, I would say. It doesn't look particularly shiny or glossy. That's what it looks like. And that's just with one couple of swipes, not very hard swipes, on the back of my hand. So it's kind of like a brownie pinky nude. Gotta smell it. No discernible smell, and that's a big plus. I don't particularly like scented products nowadays. Kind of affects my nose. And the next one is called Slow Burn. And that looks like your more typical nude. It's got a lot more pink rosiness in it. And let's swatch that. Oh yeah. It's definitely a lighter pink in there. You can see Not quite sure that that color would suit me as much as the first one, No Angel. I find that when it's much too pink like that, makes my skin look really odd and make my entire face look really odd as well. So, not too sure about that color. Next one I'm really excited about. This one is called O'Miley, and I've got a feeling it's named after Miley Cyrus. I'm not sure. Maybe someone can tell me down below. But it is this amazing hot neutral red color, and that really looks cool. Oh yeah. There you go. That is a true kind of leaning slightly warm red. Don't know if it's focusing very well. There we go. So that would look amazing on anyone for a night out. I think that is so cool. And I could see a little bit of a difference in the formula between the kind of neutrals and the red. The red looks a little bit more shinier, a little bit more creamier as well. So, just like it doesn't quite go into the bullet. I'm really hoping I don't mess up lipstick essentially. So it looks a little bit creamy. Now I always have difficulty with creamy lipsticks of any sort. They go all over my face, they kind of rub off, they're not fantastically just staying there, but we'll see. And the next one is called Miss Scarlet, and this looks like what it will be, a very nice plum. Do find that there's a bit of like most of the lipsticks aren't perfect in the bullet. It does hit the cap a little bit. I don't know if you can see that. That looks like it's a deeper shade of red. Oh, okay, it is so creamy though. That feels really, really nice. If you're a type of person who'd like creamy lipsticks, I think you might actually enjoy these. So that's Miss Scarlet. It's a deeper red and it looks amazing as well. I think that I would really enjoy using. And then finally, we have what is called Scandal. And this looks like a plum, a true kind of violet plum color. Look at how dark that is. Let's see what that actually swatched like. It's a little patchier. If you run a couple of times more swatch on my hand, and that is what it looks like. It actually comes out a lot more violet, and you can see it's a little patchier than the others. I hear that purple is really hard to get right. I don't know whether that's the same in the lipstick formula, but that is what it looks like. So I think I'm gonna try. That'll be the prayer call, so that will keep going. I'm gonna try, I think, what is it called? No Angel and maybe Miss Scarlet and see what that is like on my lips. I'm gonna get a mirror and I'll be right back. What I'm gonna try on my lips is No Angel, and it was the light brownie nude color. Not really sure how this is gonna work. It's a really tiny applicator. Oh wow, the formula is really, really creamy. It just kind of went right over my lips really easily. I have really dry lips at the moment, so it didn't tug, just glide really, really nicely. This is obviously quite a pale color. And that's what it looks like. I think that's quite nice for a everyday, you want something really simple, and I think that would look quite nice on quite a few different skin tones as well. I quite enjoy that. I don't know if you can see. So that is No Angel, and I'm gonna move on to the next one. Now, in between lip swatches, I'm just taking the lipstick off with a little bit of Bioderma, and then I pat a little bit of foundation over just to get rid of the color and move on to the rest. So it is dry. And there's nothing on my lips. And the next color I'm gonna try is Miss Scarlet, which is that deep red. Let's see how this performs. I was really excited about the swatch on my hand. That is really pigmented. Gonna see if I can neaten the lines a little bit. That is Miss Scarlet. Now, this is a formula and the type of lipstick I probably have to use a lip brush with to clean up the lines and probably put a little bit of lip liner on, make sure it's kind of a little bit more perfect, but it feels really great on the lips. Again, that is really, really creamy. And it's just a great color. I'll show you if you can see. So obviously I'm putting it in front of a camera. It's not gonna be perfect, but so far so good. I really like that. I'm gonna go take these off and let's show you what the Kat Von D lipsticks are like. This is the Kat Von D Everlasting Mini Liquid Lipstick Set, and I'm again really, really excited to see what this is like. So let's open it up. Ooh, okay. Not really sure how this is positioned, but okay. Basically, all of the lipsticks just came out. It doesn't come boxed in anything, so it just basically rolled out. That's all right. Let me stuff this back in again. I'll have to look at the shades. Let's see. Ooh, there's a lot in here. This is all of the lipsticks. I can't even hold all of them. There we go. Kind of. Oh. All of them. There's a lot of different colors, and they are literally just mini sizes of the normal ones. Just like the Marc Jacobs, this is reminiscent of the, I'm gonna drop things here. This is reminiscent of the Kat Von D liquid lipstick packaging, and I love the fact that they kept the beautiful silver ink tattoo design that she has on the caps of the liquid lipstick. There we go. And it's just absolutely beautiful. So it obviously didn't skimp on anything. Now, there's just so many. Okay, let's go. I'm gonna go through them in order as they are on the box. So the first one, it says it should be Santa Sangre. So, Santa Sung, butchering the name, I am so sorry. I am gonna probably regret this. Let's see, just gonna put them where they are gonna stay. I'm hoping that I'm not gonna drop them. So, this is Santa Sung. It looks to be a red. Smells a little bit chemically, there's no scent at all, and I'm just going to swatch this at the back of my hand. Oh, so stunning, like really pigmented, and that is a what looks to be a warm base red. Now it looks a little bit shiny and glossy at the moment, but I do know that they dry down, so I'm going to show you all of the swatches once they have dried down as well, and then you can see what they actually look like. So that is the red. Next is mother. Let's see if I can find. Yep, that's this one. This is from her normal range. I think Santa Sangre is as well. So there's two new colors in here and they are at the end. So all of the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there's six of them that are part of her normal line. So it's quite good to pick them up and try them out and see whether you like them before picking up a bigger full size. So this is Mother and it looks to be a pink toned everyday color. Kind of a bit neutral, I suppose. It's one of those colors that are a little bit more neutral than others. So yeah, it's definitely pink based. There we go, that's what it looks like. Looks a little bit Barbie like in the camera, but a little bit more subdued on the swatch. Next is Lovesick, which I think is this one. Yes, Lovesick. This one looks to be a paler pink shade, a bit more gray toned, I think. It's got a little bit of purple paleness in there, and that is Lovesick. Next is a super bright pink. It's called Backstage Barbie, Bambi, and it's described as a vivid hot pink. Oh, okay, so surprisingly, Mother is called a dusty mauve pink. I can't say that word. Lovesick is a mauve nude. Not quite sure what sort of nude that is, but it's not nude. And this is definitely a hot Barbie pink. There we go. For someone who really likes attention, I think. If you're feeling really amazing and you're going to a club, I think this would be the shade for you. Oh yeah. Surprisingly, that looks a little patchy. It's a little bit sheer on the back of my hand. That is what it looks like. So that is called Backstage Bambi. Now we're coming to shades which I am really excited about. I'm hoping, yes. This is called LUV, Love, and it is described as a rich violet, and this is what it looks like. I've been really getting into my plums and my purples and my violets at the moment, and this looks really cool. See what that's like. That's pretty. So a kind of light violet shade, still very wearable. I think it's got a little bit of pink in there that makes it wearable. I think that would look absolutely amazing against darker skin tones or really, really pale skin as well. So that's exciting. And then we have Echo. Echo. This looks like a straight up blue. Like, I don't know if you can see. That is Echo, and it's described as a satin navy blue. So this is described as a satin navy blue, and this looks like the type of color that I would not wear out at all. Oh yeah, that's definitely blue. It's not even purple. It's not even wanting to be purple. That is just straight up blue. Scary. I'm not sure that I would wear that color, but that would look amazing in an editorial. So there we go. Now, one of the newer shades is called Plath. It's a deep russet red, and I was quite excited about this shade as well. It looks like a browny red. Oh yeah. Very, very pretty. Also, some of them definitely come off a little bit sheerer than others. That is amazing pigmentation. It looks like a deep kind of this warm toned red. Really, really amazing color. I'm quite excited about that. If you saw, what was that shade called? Echo. next to it is you can definitely see that it's a little bit patchy. So is LUV next to it. I can see where it's kind of snagged on the skin, and Backstage Bambi as well. The lighter shades, surprisingly, are quite pigmented and they've dried down really nicely at the top. So the red shade is called Plath. And then the final shade in this entire collection is called Roxy, and it's called a described as a bright grape. And this is straight up purple. Nearly dropped it. That gave me a little bit of a heart attack. So let's see. Oh yeah. I think I've got to try at least one of the crazy shades and just show you what that's like. But that is Roxy. Little bit patchy as well. So surprisingly, a few patchy shades, but overall interesting set of colors. The feeling I kind of feel like I could use the Marc Jacobs one a little bit more, just because the colors are ones that I can use. It's a little bit neutral. I wouldn't say it was neutral. There's some shades in there which were quite far out, but a little bit more wearable, I think. But these shades are really fun. Like, they just look really fun and quite cool. Overall, quite cool toned, I think. And let's see. Should definitely get to swatch them on my lips. I can't really decide what I want to go for. I think I will try one of the neutrals and then one of the crazy colors, or maybe I should go for the bright pink and another crazy color. I have no idea. I'm kind of stuck. I don't know. Okay, you know what? I'm never ever gonna wear the blue one, so I'm gonna try it anyway and show you what it looks like in a video. It's possibly gonna be horrifying, but I think it'll be interesting. And then I might I'm kind of torn between Love and Backstage Bambi. I really like the look of Love. I love the purple, so I'm gonna try that and see what it's like. I'm trying out LUV Love on my lips, and we're gonna hope this goes well. Actually really like that. Kind of looks really cool. Dry down immediately on the lips, and that was just one swipe. I even took off most of the excess on the bottleneck as well. So that was one swipe around my lips. I have pretty small lips anyway, so you might find you have to go back for another swipe, but this looks really pigmented. I can definitely see where it's caught a little bit in the dark patches, but overall, really nice. I really like the color. I will definitely wear this again, so. That was Love, and I'm gonna show you what the blue looks like. So that was really hard to get rid of. You can still see LUV residue on my lips. Definitely didn't come off, and it basically took half my face with it. So definitely long lasting. Now the next shade is called Echo. ECHO. I can't say that name really loudly because that Amazon machine in my bedroom would wake up and start making noise. So this is the shade, and I'm gonna show you what it looks like on my lips. I really don't know how this will go. Oh dear. It is really patchy. Can't really get it to let's do another dab. Not really sure about this. So feeling I'm gonna come up with blue lipstick on my teeth. This is about as much of a coverage I think I can get. It's really odd because as I keep trying to build up the pigment, every time I press my lips together, it just wipes the pigment away from my bottom lip, and it looks like the top lip is not too bad. It's actually quite pigmented, it's quite covered, but the bottom one is definitely. There's a little bit off. So, not a big fan, but I like dark lip look. The fact that it's blue, the more I look at it, the more I'm like, ooh, kind of going to an emo phase. I think it's actually quite a beautiful color. I can see where it's going, and if there's another blue lipstick out there with a better formulation than this one, I might actually wear it out. Quite cool. What do you think? Would you ever wear blue lipstick? Tell me in the comments below. But in terms of the formula, I think this one kind of fails a little bit. You could see from the other one that I tried on LUV, even though on the swatch was a little bit patchy, on the lips actually it looks really, really good. It was one swipe. This one I had to go a couple of swipes, and even then it was really hard to even out and just didn't look quite good in the end. So I will take this off and be right back. And that were the swatches for the Marc Jacobs Up All Night Lip Kit, as well as the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick set on my lips. So taking everything off, it was really hard to get the Kat Von D stuff away. To basically like tree soaked pads of Biodermo to get it off. Something on my nose. And I put another lipstick on, so did a little bit of a chemistry mix. I've got Slow Burn and so Slow Burn from Marc Jacobs, and then I've got Kat Von D Mother all over my lips. And this is what it looks like. Being quite wearable every day. It's a little bit odd because I mixed two different formulas together. One's creamy and one's matte. I kind of felt like I should have done it the other way around, which was to put Mother on and then Slow Burn on top of it, but we'll know for next time. So I don't know, what do you think? Which one wins the battle of the lip sets? Let me know in the comments below which one you prefer. I really like both of them. I was quite pleasantly surprised by Marc Jacobs. I think the formula was really creamy, felt really comfortable on the lips, and the shades are really, really nice. And the bag is just gorgeous. I'm really looking forward to actually taking that out. And the Kat Von D one was surprising with the colors, that I actually quite liked the more out there shades. Loving the purple, surprisingly like the blue, except I didn't like the formula that the blue was in. It was really patchy. And I'm not quite sure how the bright grape would look like, but it looks really cool anyway. And then I look forward to trying out the other shades. They look really nice as well. So two really kind of fantastic lip sets. And I don't think they have them anymore. I was pretty sure they are limited edition, and it came out sort of around the Christmas period, which doesn't quite help. But most of the colors in there are from their permanent ranges. So if you liked anything in Kat Von D, aside from two of the shades which were new, everything else can be found in the permanent range. And I think everything in the Marc Jacobs can be found in the permanent range as well. So if you liked any of the colors, you can go and pick them up and try them in the shop, which would be really cool. So if you like this video, don't forget to click the thumbs up button and click like below, and I definitely look forward to seeing all of you again. Let me know what you'd like me to try next, and I'll see you next time. Bye.